I turned this box of chocolate-coated peanuts into these creative flowers gift tags, and let me show you how. I started by cutting an A4 sheet of paper into 9 equal parts. Each part will be a gift tag base. Then, I will open my box by cutting it along the bending lines. This will give me easier access to cut different shapes. For this project, you can use any kind empty packages you have at home, as long as they are clean, have good quality prints, and come from non-toxic products like food, drinks, or cosmetics. Use a 6-petal flower hole puncher to cut a flower from the bigger green parts of the box. Holding the hole puncher upside down will help me center the paper better and see exactly what I'm cutting. I will also make a few 2.5 centimeters daisies. And from the smaller areas of the box, I am cutting some 1 centimeter daisies. I want to make a small daisy from this cute peanut here, so I'm cutting the package for easier access. And from these chocolate-coated peanuts, I'm making 2 big daisies and 2 small daisies. Using a regular office hole puncher, I'm cutting small circles from the remaining parts of the box, and I will use these later for the flower center parts. Now it's time to put everything together. For this, I will use a universal glue for multiple surfaces, including paper. That is not making the paper wrinkly. I will start by gluing 3 flowers on a card base. For this, I am holding my flowers upside down, add a drop of glue in the center, and spread it on the petals with a piece of leftover paper. After gluing my flowers, I'm adding the flower centers, mixing the colors. When everything is done, leave your card for 1 minute under a book or a stack of paper or some other flat, heavier object to make sure everything sticks well together. You can now draw some stems and some leaves with a black permanent marker, and you can also add some color to the leaves. For a more cartoon look, you can add some contour to your flowers. When you finish contouring, cut round corners, and your card is done. For my second card, I will glue the flowers the same way, trying to maintain a color balance. Once all the flowers are added, put the card for 1 minute under a heavy object. After the card is pressed, it's time to add the flower centers, mixing the colors. Press again for 1 minute, then cut the excess paper. Now it's time to round the corners. And your second card is done. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit like if you enjoyed this video and subscribe to get our latest handmade and homemade videos.